It's time for another Read and Reviewed. This is amazingly another three fantastic books to share with you. I cannot wait to tell you all about them, so we better get started. And welcome back to my channel. It's Russell with Ink and Paper Blog. How are you doing today? I hope you are doing wonderful. I hope that your reading is doing as well as mine is doing. I am so ecstatic. I'm reading so many things that I'm absolutely loving, and I cannot wait to share them with you. I have just been checking in on my 2019 reading goal. My reading goal was 75 books, which I have already passed. Luckily, I set that a little bit lower than I know I can achieve, just in case. You never know what life is going to throw at you. So I'm 6 books away from 100 books for 2019, which is about where I have landed every year previously. So I'm happy that I'm almost there. And that means I've shared 94 books with you after this video that I have read this year. So that is actually super duper exciting. And all three of the books that I'm going to talk about today have actually been out there and talked about quite a bit, but I wanted to give you guys my opinion on them because I absolutely loved all three of these. So get out your pen, get out your paper, get out your Goodreads, however you keep track of your TBR. Please do so. If you are so able, please order these books from your local independent bookstore, and or if you are a library user, have your library pick them up for you and get your name on them, because you are going to want to read them, I promise. Okay, let's get started. The first book I want to tell you about is Celestial Bodies by Joca Alharthy. This is published in the US by Catapult, and I have to thank Catapult. I bought this version of it myself, but they did send me the early review copy, and I am so happy they did because I loved it so much I got a copy to go on my shelf. Joca Alharthy actually, in this book, was fantastic for a lot of reasons. One, it is a great novel. Two, Joca is from the country of Oman, which I had heard about, but did not know a lot of information on. So what was really fantastic about this book is the amount of research it made me do into the history of Oman, the culture of that country, and just getting myself sort of surrounded by it was really, really interesting. I learned a ton, not only from the book, but also from the research that she encouraged me to do. Now, this is translated from the Arabic by Marilyn Booth, I believe. Marilyn Booth, that is correct. And it was the winner of the 2019 Man Booker International Prize. And Joca is the first woman from Oman to have a novel translated into English, is what the back of this, her little blurb says. And that is fantastic. And then it wins the Man Booker International Prize. So there you go. Enough said, right? I don't need to say anymore. This is a family saga. This is really the story of three sisters and their lives and how they each deal differently with the idea of marriage. We have the oldest sister who is placed into an arranged marriage with a man that she does not love or really even know. We have the middle sister who sort of revolts against tradition, waiting for a man that she has been promised to. And we have the youngest sister who has a completely different take on marriage and has an excitement and drive to be a mother that is infectious when we get into her sections. Now, all of these, this book is actually told from many different perspectives, from many different parts of the family. We have it from the oldest daughter's husband on a plane, sort of giving his perspective on his wife and his relationship. Each of the sisters have their own sections. Their parents have their own sections. There's the discussions of infidelity. There's discussions of loyalty to the family. There's also just discussions about the economic and political structure of the country and how that sort of plays out in all of these other dynamics. It's a hard book to describe without really giving away what goes on in it. And one of the absolute treats of this book was I didn't know much about it going into it. And as I got immersed into this family and to Joca's writing and her language and the people, I flew through it. I thought it was a beautifully written book. I really enjoyed all of the characters. She has a way of creating people that just seem so real and visceral, and their decisions are just you know, you just struggle with them. She also does a very nice job of describing some food that is delicious sounding. Yeah, she is a phenomenal, phenomenal writer, and this is a great, great book. So if you like books about family, a family saga told about children and their sort of discussion as they grow up from all different points of view, so you get to sort of the honor of putting it all together in that package as it comes together, and you can do those moments of, oh, I remember why that is important now that I've gotten to this section. Yeah, this is the book for you. If I would say if you liked Pinchenko by Min Jin Lee, something along that, this book would definitely be for you. So that is Celestial Bodies by Joka Alharthi, translated from the Arabic by Marilyn Booth. Let me make sure. I keep wanting to say Marilyn's name is Megan, and I know that that's wrong, so let me make sure. And it is Marilyn Booth, thank you. And this is out again in the US from Catapult. Highly, highly recommend. And then just dive into the fascinating cultural history of the country of Oman. I watched a fantastic YouTube series that goes into the history and politics and food and culture of different countries that did, and I watched the Oman one, and then I wound up getting sucked into all of these different countries. But yeah, it was very much worth the time. And yeah, I loved it. The next book is the winner of the 2019 Man Booker co-winner. But now that I have read both of the winners of the Booker Prize for this year, in my mind, there was a clear winner, and that is Girl, Woman, Other, by Bernardine Evaristo. This book is brilliant. I did this as a buddy read with my friend Jacqueline over at 6 Minutes to Me, and we were both absolutely stunned by the brilliance that is this book. Now, this is a book where you can almost argue it's like a collection of interconnected short stories. It is 4 sections. The first 3 sections, let me make sure I'm saying that right. It's 5 sections and an epilogue. The first 4 sections are separated into the point of view of 3 different women. And what you find out is one of the women is the girl, one is the woman, and one is the other. A lot of the times it's a mother and a daughter and then a friend or a teacher. And it sort of starts to wrap all of the packages together. This book is written in a very unique style. It's like one ginormous long prose poem. I found it very interesting. There's no punctuation other than the use of a comma here and there. There's no capitalization other than on proper nouns. So it really does flow. I sort of explained this to other people. When you're sitting on the beach and you're in the sand and the waves are sort of lapping over you, and all of a sudden you sort of just feel that calmness of them sort of sucking you into the ocean, that is what Bernardine Evaristo's style is in this book. It took a minute, but once she sort of starts to just layer it on, you sort of get into the rhythm of the book, you will just totally buy into the beauty of her language. The art of her craft is phenomenal. This is really a book that focuses on the lives of Black women in the UK from many different perspectives, from the immigrant perspective, from the naturalized citizen perspective, from wealthy to poor to educated to people who are doing everyday jobs, just getting through life. Every character is distinct in and of herself, and every character really discusses something interesting from the educational system and the change of the educational system through time. We have 2 characters that are teachers in the book who give a very fascinating perspective on that. We have a lot of mother-daughter interaction that is very, very, very well done. We have people who decide in their youth that they are going to get themselves out of the situation of their parents and, you know, succeed at a different level than their parents or in a different way than their parents. We have a transgender man character who is fascinating. Bernardine Evaristo does an amazing job of explaining his story from how he determined who he was going to be, how he identified his own gender, and then really a discussion about gender in a very sort of educational, but also emotional and well thought out way. It's just beautifully done. Many different perspectives, all really well done. And when they all wrap up, sort of the, I should say, the main theme of the book is that our main, the first character we meet, her name is Alma, is putting on a play. She has finally been able to put on this production that she's written. And a lot of these characters are going to attend that play and in our some way connected with the people that are attending. And so at the end, we have, after the play has finished, we have sort of everything come together as the characters see each other after we have learned their story. It is so good. Don't take my word for it. Take everybody else's word for it, because a lot of people really loved this book and it was really worth my time. It made me, this is one of those books where I was like, I clearly need to get all of Bernardine Evaristo's backlist because I have been missing out on a literary genius. So that is Girl, Women, Other by Bernardine Evaristo. It's out by Black Cat in this beautiful paperback edition here in the US. The UK edition is also beautiful. You can't see it, but it's up here on my shelves. My friend Kyle got it from me when he was over there in London, and it is also beautiful. So whatever edition you get, it's absolutely lovely. Highly recommend the Man Booker winner. Okay. Last but not least, my friend Chris over at Chris's Bookish Cauldron has been pushing and pushing and pushing for me to read Ann Patchett, who is his favorite author. He has guzzled down her entire catalog, and he always says to me, Russell, you have to read Ann Patchett. You have to read Ann Patchett. I tried at one point to read Bel Canto. It didn't work for me, and I just have never connected to getting back to Ann Patchett. But this is the year that Ann Patchett's novel, The Dutch House, came out from Harper. This is the advanced reading copy. I'm actually going to the bookstore today to see an author speak, and I will be picking up a copy of this for my shelf because I loved this book. And I am now officially, Chris, I can tell you, on the Ann Patchett choo-choo train. The Dutch House, it's funny. This book is named after a building and a house. And yes, the house is important, but that is not what this book is about. This is the story of a brother and sister. What we learn in the very beginning is they live in a house called the Dutch House with their father. Their father is newly going to get married to a woman who comes in, a stepmother, after their mother has disappeared. She is just one day she is up and she is left, and they have been raised by their father in the Dutch House. We learn very soon thereafter, you guys come to find out that the father winds up passing away, and the children are exiled from the house by the stepmother. And this is really the story of the brother and sister. Now, it's told from the point of perspective of the brother, Danny. Danny is very interesting. He sort of idolized his father. His father went from rags to riches, all by using and purchasing and selling and owning real estate in the Pittsburgh area. And Danny is fascinated with that, and that's all he wants to do. His older sister, Maeve, is smart, sassy, strong, fantastic. I could have done with a whole book all about Maeve. Could have had this book be from her perspective, and I would have loved it probably even more than I did now. She is a fantastic character who loves her brother very, very much. And what winds up happening is, after they are kicked out, they are really left destitute, and they're back in the situation that their father and mother were in before the father sort of changed the time, changed the family outcome. And so it's very interesting how they go from one to the other and how they really have to rebuild their lives. What happens is, due to some money left in a trust, Danny goes to college and he winds up becoming a doctor, but his real passion is real estate. And we learn about the dynamics between him and his sister, them and their father. We learn about what happened with their mother, why she, what that sort of dynamic did to these children as they were growing up. We learn more about the stepmother, who is interesting as an evil stepmother type character. She has a lot of validity in sort of the, I would have been interested to know what was going on in her head, because some of the stuff she says, I could see why she felt the way she would, all from the perspective of Danny. So you know how if another character says something or has an interaction with a character and you don't know what's going on in that character's head, but you can kind of understand what they're saying back to you. I thought that was very, very interesting. This book is really about love and connection and family. And it's really about how people grow up and how, when even life changes, sometimes All you need is one person to love you through it all. The prose are delicious. The descriptions are great. The characters are well thought out. It is a book with not a lot of plot, which you know I absolutely love because I don't need a lot of plot. But it really is just about these two people growing up after all of this change occurs in their life. Maeve is one of my favorite characters that I have read about in 2019, and I absolutely loved her. So that is The Dutch House by Ann Patchett, and this is out from Harper now, and I highly, highly recommend it. I actually highly, highly recommend all three of these amazing books. They are amazing. So please, please get them on your TBR if you haven't read them already. Let's talk about them in the comments below if you have read them. As always, I encourage you to shop locally, read globally, and until next time, I wish you happy reading, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!